डियर स्टूडेंट्स अस्सलाम वालेकुम, होप यू आर ग्रेटली ब्लेस्ड एंड हैड अ ग्रेट टाइम ऑफ ईद हॉलीडेज। लेट्स स्टार्ट द लेसन द वर्ल्ड ऑफ बुक्स एंड टुडे वी विल डू बुक एक्टिविटीज फ्रॉम बुक पेज नंबर 6, 7 and 8। एंड पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच इट्स आवर मेन फोकस एंड इन मेन पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच our focus will be on noun and its kind. What are parts of speech? There are 8 parts of speech. Their names are noun, adjective, pronoun, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction and interjection. But our main focus will be on noun and its kinds. Let's start. The first image, it shows that there's some person, there's some people. Second shows that building, it means it's a place. Third one shows that collection of different things, it means things. Third one shows freedom, an idea, an activity. An activity of happiness, freedom, enjoy. Okay, what do we understand by this? 4 images: person, place, things, or an idea. What is a noun? Noun is a name of a person, place, thing, or an idea. Here are some examples. Like in person, we have the Maria name. Maria, girl, neighbor, Sialkot, town, city, it's a place. Food included in the category of the thing, food, bag, book, fox. Fourth one is honesty, freedom and kindness. It's included in the idea. In short, we can say that noun is the name of a person, place, thing or an idea. In other words, if we simplify it more, further, noun is the name of anything. Dear students, here some examples. You will underline noun from book page number 6. Raja is a good boy. He learns his lessons daily. He always comes first in his class. Dear students, you will underline the nouns which are present in the these 3 sentences. Let's try to know what are the kinds of the noun. In kinds of noun, we have the 5 kinds: common noun, proper noun, collective noun, material noun, and the last one is abstract noun. Let's see what are they. Common noun and proper noun. It's a place. It's a place, it's mean United States of America. It's a map of the United States of America. It means it's a particular place. Second one shows a house, but it's not clear which kind of the house, whose house it means. We can consider it general, common. When we specify, it means it's a particular. When we say that, it's a common, general, unknown, unclear. It's common. Noun can be common. If the noun is common, then mean we are discussing about the general. And the second image shows that this is a common noun. If this place will be a particular, then it will be a proper noun. First image shows that particular place, it means specific area, specific place. Here are some examples that will make our concept very clear. Girl, boy, town, school, subject, city, province, country. If we don't mention particular, specify, that is the common. If we specify, that will be the proper noun. Let's see the example. Sadia, Zain, Desko, लर्निंग जोन स्कूल सिस्टम इंग्लिश इस्लामाबाद सिंध पाकिस्तान. इट मीन्स वेन वी स्पेसिफाई पर्सन प्लेस थिंग एनीथिंग दैट बिकम्स अ प्रॉपर. इफ वी डोंट स्पेसिफाई इफ वी डिस्कस इन जनरल दैट विल बी द कॉमन नाउन. Here we can differentiate further. Girl, if we say just girl, it means it's a common. If we say give a name to that girl, that become a proper. If we see a country, if we see a Pakistan, it means we are specifying a country. It means we are discussing about a particular country. Pakistan, that becomes a proper noun. Okay, what's the difference? Here's proper nouns are always capitalized. It means the first letter of the proper noun is always capital. In example, we can see that first letter of girl is small. It's so common. And the first letter of the Sadia, it's a capital. Because Sadia is a proper noun. And one thing that you have to remember that proper nouns are always capitalized. Okay, collective noun. Flock of birds, bunch of flowers, army of soldiers, an army of ants. It's also remember. Group of students, student, a class of students. Team of players, a herd of sheep. What do we understand by this? When we say that a flock of birds, it means flock is a collective noun. When we say that an army of ants, an army is a collective noun. When we say that an army of soldiers, it means an army is a collective noun. Class is also collective noun. Team is also collective noun. When we give a name to a group of things, that becomes a collective noun. Let's see, collective noun is a name of group of people, things, animal or place considered as one whole. When we give group of things, people, animal or place a particular name as one whole, when we consider them as whole, we call it collective noun. Hope there are so many examples that we can quote here. Flock of birds, a bunch of flowers, an army of soldiers, an army of ants, a class of students, a team of players, a herd of sheep. Dear students, you can find different examples of the collective noun. Hope you will be able to understand the today lecture easily. Thank you. And solve the book activities by understanding the lecture of today.